All right, guys, what can I say? I have no idea. But yeah, I'm now the owner of a Volvo semi-truck. I have no idea what I'm gonna do with this thing, but yeah, we're gonna do something with it. So I figured I'd show you guys around the truck. Yeah, God, I'm such an idiot. I don't know why I bought this thing. It was just too good of a deal. I couldn't pass it up. I was like, why not? Yeah, it's kind of cruddy, but you know, it's an old truck. So it's not too bad, but look at this thing. Definitely gonna make a burnout happen in this, so if it will do it. Pretty sure it will do it. Probably do it. Look at that. This is proof that I will literally buy any piece of junk that someone offers up for sale. It has a turbo. Yeah, I've had a lot of thoughts. I was thinking like it'd be cool because this is the decommissioned truck, so I don't really think it can go back on the road. Maybe you can get the title for it, I don't know. But I was thinking like we could take the cab off of it and do like some kind of cool old school rat rod or something, or part it out, make money or whatever, I don't know. But we're definitely gonna do some stuff with it before we do anything with it. Like I said, a burnout, it's gotta happen. We gotta try to do a burnout in it. And today we're gonna let Donald drive it because he thinks he's a truck driver. And he thinks he knows he can drive a truck, but yeah. I've only driven a truck around in a parking lot, and I actually drove this thing 30 minutes to the house.
Okay, because I'm the worst YouTuber in the world, I didn't think to bring my camera equipment, but just picked the truck up from where I work. I have no idea what I'm doing. I don't have my CDL. Probably definitely shouldn't be recording right now, but forgive me. I just wanted to share this moment with you guys. I'm like terrified I don't want to get pulled over. But I did wait till like 2 a.m. to come pick it up. There's no one on the highway. Figured that'd be safer for everybody. I don't even know if I'm in the high gear or not. I'm hearing a lot of turbo noise, so I don't feel like I am. But it's pretty cool though.
And it's difficult. So if you drive a truck as a profession, hats off to you. It is way more difficult than it looks. Yeah, it's difficult. So he's so confident, we're about to take this thing down the road and we'll let him drive it. But since we don't have a passenger seat, I got a solution though. Hold on, you guys are gonna like this. Oh yeah, see that's safety right there, especially with someone that doesn't know what they're doing. So I'm sure I'm gonna be safe right there.
Yeah. I'm not going nowhere.
He's very confident. I'm not very confident though. Yeah, let's shut the, I don't even know what you call this thing. Is it still called the hood? Call it the hood? Jump in this bad boy real quick. I'm going back down the road because I got a lot of cars in my yard. But it runs pretty good. Let's see. Yeah, turbo noise. Yeah, I did not think driving a manual truck would be this difficult, but it is. So, sit you guys right here. Yeah, we're gonna try to do a 3-point turn in my yard. I got like power lines hanging down that I can't hit. Hey, close. About to run into my house now. Yeah, driving a manual
that drives manual cars, you figure it'd be easy, but it's a totally different experience for sure. It's kind of sketchy because it only has like the little bitty wheels in the front. So if you go like, it don't break, the thing wants to like just slide the back tires. Trimming the trees a little bit. Sounds so horrible. Down my one-way street, and there are trees literally like overhanging like crazy. This is going to be pretty funny getting out of here. This is
going to
be interesting, guys.
Let me jump on over here.
This is stupid. I don't even have a seatbelt.
Dang, it's hot. Here, we need to get some window down. Some window down action.
Don't be breaking my dash, buddy. High quality. Don't be breaking the Volvo.
Alright. So what you want to do? You want me to give you advice or to let you go?
Yeah,
alright. Let loose up the shift. Alright, forward is gonna be like a low range gear, yeah. That's your little switcher right there, which we'll get into that in a second. That should be first. You don't have to give it any gas. Just let off the clutch. No clutch, just pull back for a second. Uh-huh. Uh-huh. What's that? Yeah, when I first started driving this thing, I was like, oh, geez. Oh, we rocking. Watch these trees. Watch these trees. My freaking driveway, my fucking, this one-way street is sketchy in this big thing. Oh, jeez. Yeah, it's just an H pattern, but it's kind of wide weight because you have to stop right here anyway. And like I said, the brakes are kind of sensitive. So.
I told you the brakes are sensitive.
Yeah, they're sensitive, man. It's crazy.
About went out the freaking windshield.
Smell tires. What'd you do?
Huh?
Oh, you didn't leave no black mark.
Yeah, it only has like the two tires in the back. So like, if you barely get on the brakes, they won't lock up.
You got a clutch in? Press it all the way in and try. Sometimes if it don't go in, if you let up on the clutch a little bit, it'll go in. No gas, just let off the clutch. Trust me, you won't stall in a low range. Or I don't think you can. I told him this was difficult and he didn't believe me. Why don't we put our hazards on? Press that hazards button over there when you get a chance. Sensitive, I would say, because of that, but I think it'd be a whole lot better if we actually had, you know, four tires in the back, and it's just one axle truck. It's pretty cool, though. Like, I never thought I would own a semi, so this is pretty dope. Now, I think we're past the hazards since you can get up to high, you know, actual road speeds. You got her this way. Let's see if you can do better this time.
High range.
I'll try. There we go. I remember someone saying those exact very words when I was driving at home. Yeah, if you drive trucks for a living, let me know if you can actually start in a high range when you're not pulling something, because that makes more sense to me. But
I think you're supposed to start like second or third.
Is that true? Yeah, we're just goofy, and we're going to tear this truck up probably. So I kind of hope we have fun with it before it breaks. Judging by the sounds of those grinding,
it's good.
Oh yeah, it's perfectly. It's okay. Some of this thing would be cool with like an old truck cab on it or something like that. It's just like an old rat rod. I think that'd be dope. And you know, once I figure out how to drive it. So. But unfortunately, I don't have the time, the place, or anything to do stuff like that. So that's kind of I think I could do it there at the house in the yard, but I don't know. I don't think that's going to be very achievable for a man in my position right now. Get ready to brace myself. I got to stop. Yeah. Think this thing will do a burnout? I want to do a burnout in this thing so bad. How many people can say they've done a burnout in a semi? Comment below if you've done a burnout in a semi.
You got it this way.
I'm sure there's some dude that's got like one of these things souped up that was just like fried hot. Start over. We ain't even rolling. You might as well start over. Just kind of keep your foot on the gas. That helps a lot. Nope. That's reverse. Leave your foot on the gas. Just pull it straight back. Yeah. Not too bad. I probably just left it.
Yeah.
Whatever it was. If you're in high range, let the RPMs come down. Yeah. I'm giving him advice like I know what I'm doing. Yeah. I don't know. All the RPMs. All 2,500 of them. Rough ride either. They're kind of bouncy. It could just be my high school seat too, but yeah, a little rougher than I was expecting. They stole a bunch of stuff off the truck when when they decommissioned it, like the fifth wheel, the AC. So it's hot. It's all get out of this thing. I'm in the trees. Let's get some of the left side of the road. You pull in, make sure you don't roll into the MR2. If you gotta hit something, hit your truck. Just turn it in. Go to the front yard, it'll cut it. All the way turn her in. Watch the poles of the lines up there. We'll be good. Ah, we didn't die. A lot of sweat on your forehead over there, bro. Like, what, you where? Nervous?
Where?
Or is it hot in this
movie? It's hot.
It's hot in this truck. Even with the windows down, it's hot in this truck.
Well, this is a race truck right here. Man, breaking down trees. Yeah, I have no idea how I'm doing this thing. I just, like I said, to me, they were decommissioning it, and you know, I wanted the turbo off it, to be honest with you. I was like, man, that'd be cool, like on a, you know, LS hanging off the side with freaking semi turbo on it. But then they were, you know, they're saying they decommissioned it and say we could actually buy them, so I bought it. Because that's just
people like them 16 speeds and shit.
I don't know if I can even handle that. But yeah, it's got some issues. It's definitely not perfect. But yeah, we'll see what we're gonna do with this thing. I don't know. Yeah. It's gonna be fun because we have no idea what we're doing, so.
I got it for you.
You got it? Come over here and say that.
I got it good enough.
You got it towards the end?
Where I could have passed the CDL test. Anybody's willing to hire me. If you put that on the internet, somebody's gonna hire me to drive their truck.
Y'all heard the man. If you're looking for a driver, right here.
Start over.
Yeah. Definitely want this guy in front of you on your way to work in the morning.
Yeah, you would definitely get there on time. I get up and out the way once I get it in gear.
Yeah.
I just gotta, that's the story of my life. I just gotta get it in the gear.
Yeah.
And then it gets someone out the way. But until it gets in gear, it just sits there.
And that's a fact. But all right, guys. I'm sure you'll see this thing soon because, like, I don't know if it's going to sell or part out or what. But we're going to have some fun with it before we do. So in the next video, we're going to do a burnout. Burnout? Burnout. Burnout.
Burnout.
I think it'll do a burnout. But on the next video, you'll see that.
Maybe you can get some RPM and dump the clutch in fifth.
I think you just the torque. Just put it in gear and let the clutch out, and it'd probably it'd lock the front brakes up. It will do a burnout on the next video. All right, guys. Appreciate you watching, and we'll see you in the next one. This man right here, Driver of the Year Award. See you in the next one, guys.
It is more difficult than you would think, right?